So what they did is they took, there were two children who unfortunately died, probably in car accidents. And they took one of them and they took that lung. It couldn't be used for transplant. It was too damaged. And they stripped it. And they got what they call a scaffold. So it's just like the collagen and elastin. It's sort of this, think of it as the skeleton. There it is.
This is it. Okay.
This is it. That is the skeleton of the lung. And then another child had also died, also probably in a car accident. Lung couldn't be used for transplantation. And they took the cells out of that lung and they put it on top of the scaffold. And then they put it in sort of a chamber and they let it grow for a while. And voila, they got a lung. So it's a lung made actually from two real lungs, but this lung was made in a lab.
So how long before doctors can actually use these lungs in real patients?
It is going to take a long time. The researcher who did this said, look, it's going to be 10 or 12 years before we even try this out in humans. They're going to try it in pigs first, and then they'll try it in humans. They don't know if this can do what's called gas exchange, you know, exchanging all the gases that need to be done. It's really not ready for prime time at all.
Is this the beginning of possibly other body parts?
It's interesting. Some other body parts are actually further along.
Really?
Yeah, there are, like tracheas. I think you and I several years ago talked about a completely synthetic trachea that was put in a patient in 2011. And now seven patients have been given new tracheas. And for the most part, they've done quite well. So this really is a sort of a new era of engineered body parts. And the holy grail is to engineer organs because so many people are waiting for them.
Gosh, and I just think of all the individuals with lung cancer.
Right.
And yeah, I mean, this
or who
would
need
be
kidneys or livers.
Phenomenal.
I mean, it would be amazing.
Yeah. Elizabeth Cohen, thanks so much.